everyone, and welcome to another Royal Reading here at MadWorld Tarot. A gorgeous Saturday, late afternoon, early evening. I have the Deviant Moon on the tarot table for this one. I'm enjoying reading with this particular tarot deck, particularly when it comes to reading on Harry's energy, interestingly. And today we're looking at the law of unintended consequences. When it comes to Prince Harry, he's in the news possibly for all the wrong reasons today, and that's because Robert Hardman's biography of the King has been updated and it's being serialized, little excerpts from it in the Daily Mail, and we've learned a new little interesting bit of gossip. And that is, it's not gossip, I expect, being Robert Hardman, who's very well connected, particularly to the King, it must be fact. But we're going to switch the allegedly light in on and see it flashing over the cards. According to Robert Hardman, though, the reason the King avoids Harry and won't talk to him on the phone or won't be alone with him is because, basically, and this is my interpretation of it, he doesn't trust Harry. It's all to do with the court case, and in particular Harry's security case against the Home Office, the King's government. And basically, if Harry goes to court and says, well, I was chewing the fat with Pa and told Pa blah blah, and Pa said blah blah blah, that destroys the whole case right there, and it puts the King into legal and constitutional jeopardy. And so that's why the helicopter was waiting to sweep the King away when Harry did that mercy dash from Montecito when the King's cancer diagnosis was made public. And that's why the King is often on walking tours in Transylvania and all the rest of it, won't take Harry's calls, won't have anything to do with him. My words, not Robert Hardman's, my assessment of the situation, my opinion is that the King doesn't trust his own son as far as he can throw him. Basically, he knows, we speculate, that if Harry is given the opportunity to be alone with him for 5 seconds, it will be in the press, it will be all over that the King said, oh, you poor darling, you should have security, I don't understand why you don't, and that nasty government. And there it is, the end. So that's my interpretation of the situation. We're going to do a quick little 5-card reading on this. But late today, been visiting with Tess and her dad this afternoon. So as I said, all a bit late. But anyway, lovely it was to see them. And I do miss my baby Tess very much. Anyway, might be babysitting her for a while again early next year. We'll see what happens. Anyway, let's get to the cards and see what's going on with this trust issue. I want to know about the King and this feeling of jeopardy when it comes... Ooh, cards flying. When it comes to the court case, trust issues. Very important trust issues. I have to scooch over there and get that and shuffle it back in. I want to know how Harry felt reading this, because we know he reads every word that's written about him, even if he has to, put his finger under the line and trace each letter and mouth it out and make the sounds. So how he feels about this, and is he going to have some sort of regret about this? Because we are today on the topic of regret, basically, for me as a tarot reader. And of course, I am just a tarot reader. This is just for fun and entertainment, or my opinion or speculation. Just read energy here, and disclaimer in the box below, I've got the Queen of Swords. That's Princess Anne. My opinion. Oh, well, who's sitting underneath her in reverse is our darling hermit, Harry, in reverse. We'll put him there next to his aunt. That's my opinion of her. My sense energetically in these readings, particularly recently, interestingly, is that Princess Anne is playing the role of the late Queen, or even Prince Philip as the enforcer of the royal family. And it's interesting that Andrew's money has been taken away, his stipend or whatever it was that the King was paying him. And also his private security that the king was paying for all gone as of the 1st of November. So I think the enforcer is at work here, and I think the enforcer is the reason why the king realizes he cannot be alone with Harry. He cannot be on the phone with Harry because it could be distorted, it could be twisted, it could be really put to use against the king and against the courts as well, and against due process and all those kinds of things. My opinion, of course, allegedly flashing. But there is the Queen of Swords. That's the strategic, the intelligent, the hard as nails female energy that sees it. And I don't say she doesn't have a heart, but she's mature enough and wise enough and shrewd enough to say you have to think with your head, not with your heart. Your treacherous little brat of a son, my words, not hers, you can't trust him, not while all this is going on again, on, and probably not ever. Interesting energy, our little two card reading there as our underlying energy. Let's have a look at the situation we're dealing with, or the king is dealing with this Jeopardy situation. I've got the Seven of Cups and it's in reverse. The scales have fallen from his eyes. If he was ever in any doubt about Harry's intentions, honor and his integrity and all of those things, he is no longer upright. It's the card of delusion in reverse. It's the card of the ice cold bucket poured over your head, you know, a sort of Wim Hof method, in the cold water, the freezing water every morning, just to remind you of your own reality. And the king is now having that experience with Harry. He can't kid himself that beneath the surface and away from Meghan Markle, there's a dear, sweet, darling boy who is true blue. Not. That's what that Seven of Cups tells me in reverse. And of course, it's my strident opinion that I'm expressing here and speculating wildly through the agency of tarot. Let us see about this Jeopardy situation. What do the cards have to tell us about the court case and the king's feelings, or somebody else's feelings, about the difficulty, the legal and constitutional difficulty the king might get himself into if he is ever alone with his son? Amazing, isn't that amazing? Got the Four of Cups and it's in reverse. It's the rejection and apathy card and the knowledge that he has to reject Harry. He has to keep saying no. Whatever is coming out, I'm reading this card a little bit differently to the way I normally do. It is the rejection and apathy card. In reverse, I'd say it's a give another chance to somebody, and try and be a bit more enthused about something if you get the chance again. Not now, not the way that I'm reading this, not with this energy around it, not at all. This underlying energy in this situation, this Four of Cups for me, whatever offer comes from Montecito, oh, I know you're so ill and I can help you and I can lay the wreath on Remembrance Sunday, and I can open Parliament and I can do Trooping the Colour and she can come along too, because she's Mummy Diana too and everybody loves her so much. And you might even be able to see Archie and Lilibet, who we've withheld from you to spite you and manipulate you and blackmail you. My opinion, yes, strident opinion. No, going to reject it. The phone call, oh, it's the has-been on the phone, Your Majesty. No, I'm out gardening. I won't be back in for the next 3 weeks. Tell him to go away. So, trust. I've already got the Seven of Cups in reverse, and I've got old Queen of Swords here, who's sharpening that sword. Really, that sword's already got blood on it, as you can see, that blood dripping there from the top of that, the point of that sword. So, trust. Let's talk about trust. I do love tarot. The moon. And what does the moon mean? Distrust, literally. It's one of the classic meanings of the moon. don't trust. You're walking in the woods in the moonlight and you see shadows and you hear noises and you don't know what it is because it's dark and it's weird and it's creepy and it's scary. And if someone comes up to you in that dark and says, I can show you the way, and they've got very big teeth, don't trust them. A little bit of underlying energy in there. We'll just have to remind you that the moon is Mummy Diana card as well. And he might finally have learned his lesson about that kind of energy. She was quite a slippery character, she was, even though it only really became evident when Harry and Meghan set to destroying the royal family and then started excavating stories. And well, they didn't, but other people started to say, well, actually, you know what? She was quite good at playing the press and playing the king and playing everyone as well. And a lot of people now say that the king was the real victim of Diana and not the other way around. It's, you know, it depends on your interpretation and where your loyalties lie. I don't have loyalties in this, really. It's their business. I just read the cards as they pop up, and that's Diana energy. But really, the king does not trust Harry at all. Moon. Harry. How did Harry feel when, wherever he is, over his breakfast cereal, somebody had ironed the newspaper and presented it to him? I doubt that's how it goes in Montecito. When he crawled off the floor with the carpet burn and the gaming console and all the rest of it, that and the whatever he'd been smoking burned holes on the carpet, and saw his phone where he obviously sits and scrolls through social media and the Daily Mail. What did he think when he saw this? Ace of Pentacles in the reverse. He knows that this is a roadblock. And I'm going to be looking in the next reading, another unintended consequences reading, another regret reading. The road back to Buckingham Palace, the road back to some light roiling duties, is well and truly blocked. Ace of Pentacles in reverse. He realized that. Absolutely. King doesn't trust him. King can't be on his own with him for 1 second. King thinks the court case is the worst thing that he ever did. King will not allow him back. That road is blocked, that road to stability, to financial security, the long road that he was on, born with a silver spoon, could have had the life of luxury and ease and some light roiling duties, been the most popular royal, all his flaws hidden from everybody. They were expert at managing him and at covering up for him and all the rest of it. Gone. Ace of Pentacles in reverse. What's notable about that Ace of Pentacles is it's a money consequence for him. He squeezed all the money that he can out of his royal adjacency by doing the Netflix documentary and writing Spare. There's nothing else to squeeze. Regrets for the has-been? And I have the Two of Cups in reverse. Oh yes. Oh yes. Because he knows it's the breakup card, the Splitsville card. It is the card of being separated from somebody you really love. It doesn't have to be a romantic somebody. Brother, sister-in-law, aunt, cousins, father, British public, England. Got to go and live in Portugal. Not that Portugal is a horrible place, not at all, lovely place, but it's not home and it's destroyed. And he is the one who's destroyed this trust, broken this relationship, and realizes now it's over. That's the reading. Thanks for watching. I'll see you on the next one.